When you open up your analyzer, you can go into the presentation builder icon here and press new presentation here. Give it a name, select OK. Then the presentation builder environment are going to open up like this. Now, you can now go and get the videos from your desktop or any other location on your computer. Just press the plus button here. Select the video files that you want in your presentation. Select open. Then it can appear here. You can also go back to the analyzer. And here you can send any clips from the game navigator or from your clips that you already made, event sets or anything. And let's view events from this game here. And here I can select the clips that I want into my presentation. Right click, send to presentation. Select the presentation that I'm going to have it in. I'm going to just add to this one. Select OK. I can see I have my clips here from the presentation builder. And now I'm ready to start work. First of all, you can of course move the scrubber to any place that you want to do something in your video. And you can press the play button here. You can also use the space bar to play and pause. And if you hover over the buttons here, you're going to see the shortcut. So E is to jump between clips. And W is to jump back. If you select the clip here, you can of course drag it over here. You can make any clip shorter or longer. And if you click the button here in the top, in the bottom corner, you can make this fit to the screen here. Press this button here and then you get the full size. So you can full screen the video monitor and move it to a bigger screen if you want. You're going to see all the clips that are in your timeline here on the right side here. So you drag around to make the clips at the precise time if you want. Now you can double click on the gap to close it. You can hold down shift and push all the clips back and forth. Otherwise you can just drag them up and over like this. Or you can multi-select clips like this and then drag everything around. Undo and redo. If you press down command and Z, you're going to do undo. If you do command shift and C, you're going to redo. You can resize your panel by hovering the mouse over in this window here, and then you can drag it up and down. You can then start adding things. I'm going to add an image, for example. So I'm going to just place my scrubber where I want to have an image. Click on the image icon here, go to my desktop or something, and add the image. And here I can make this longer also. So I could actually move these clips here. I can control the length of this one. Double click, close the gap. And then I can press this one again to make it fit here. I'm going to go somewhere in my video. Here I want to add a drawing to this clip. So I just press the drawing button and add something. Once you've done with your drawing, you press OK. And then you can see the clip with the drawing. And you can now remove the scrubber a little bit here. Let's say you want to move all these clips here. You can decide how long this drawing stays. And then you can just close this. Now here I want to add a text box, for example. So I'll just press text here. Here I can write in anything I want. I can drag this around. If I double click it, I'm going to get the info here. So, and here's a tip. If you press a dash and spacebar, dash and spacebar like this, and then you just close it, you're going to get the bullets here. Okay. And then you decide how long this text box stays. And I want to have this a little bit longer on here. I could also add another text here, and then I would go to this button here, add track, and then I can see I've added a track here. And if I go back here and press text box again, I can place it here above the other one. And in this text box, I could, for example, select property and I can select comments or something from the analyzer. If you have something in your formula that you want to come with. So I'm going to have, let's say, comments here. I can auto-generate this so I get the comments for all the clips that I have in my timeline. I'm not going to do that, but if you want to have on all your clips, just press yes. Then I say no here. And I close this. And then I have a comment also on my clip. So I've moved my mouse here. Here I'm going to add a screen like this. And if I select this one, here I could add a text box into this screen, for example. And of course, here I can write in anything that I want. Same way, just double click. I can change the font and the size and write in any text that I want. If you want to add something from your playbook, a diagram or an animation, simply go to your playbook, go to your collections, select the diagram or the animation that you want to have, select insert into presentation, select the animation here, otherwise you would just put in one frame, select the right one here, do OK. And I'm going to select a diagram also, insert into presentation, select OK. Then I can see I have my animation here and my diagrams here, and I can of course move this anywhere on my track. If you select a clip here somewhere, you can right click, for example, to duplicate. Then you have this clip twice in your timeline here. Then you can select, for example, this clip, and I can change the speed in this one. So here it's going to be regular speed, and here it's going to be slower speed. So you can make this as you want, as many clips as you want, and you can make them faster or slower also. And of course, you can add the voiceover to your clips. Just start with a scrubber where you want the voiceover to start, and then you press this button here. It's going to add the track, and you can talk over the clip that is playing. And once you're done, you don't want to say anything more, just press this button again. And then you have your audio clip here on the extra track here. Now this one is ready. Then you can just press export and save it as an MP4 video on your desktop, for example. Or you can press share, and then you can send it to players or trainers through the system as you would share a clip normally.